Good morning, everybody. Welcome to another Daily Mark Report brought to you by Mike Bjork. Today is Monday. Happy Monday, guys. It's June 18th, and hope you guys, all the fathers out there, had a wonderful Father's Day this past weekend, and everybody else enjoyed your weekend here. Today's kind of a lighter news day today. We got one economic calendar here, and that is the NHB Home Builders Index for the month of June. So what this is, it's a survey that's brought out to the home builders and get their gauge as to the confidence level. So we had a pretty good, let's take a look here at the headline. The stock market's down. The Dow's down about a little over 150 right now. And again, it's taking its cue mostly from, in this one, it's not so much from the economic calendar, but more from the events that took place on Friday when President Trump announced the tariffs on China. And then, of course, they're placing a retaliation. And we said if we're going to retaliate, we're going to come back with some more, so which just looks like could be escalating into a trade war. So this is just being carried over from investors that they're still concerned about this. And of course, with this trade war, it prevents a lot of businesses here from expanding. So again, that's one of the concerns right there. That's the biggest concern that's on investors' minds right now. Now there's some off the news here. We had some changes here in the Fed. Over the weekend, President Dudley, the governor of Dudley out of New York, retired over the weekend. So Mr. Williams from San Francisco went over to New York. It takes that place. They always have a voting membership there. So the CEO and first president, Mark Gould, is now stepping in as interim for San Francisco governor. And then Esther George, who is the Fed governor for Kansas City, now is a voting member. So what does this mean? It basically means that what now the current structure with the voting members, it kind of makes it more of a hawkish tone here. So instead of having more of a balance, now it's going to be a bit more hawkish. So when they do their voting here coming up, September, there's expected to be a rate hike, and then there was a 50-50 chance in December. That could be swayed to a greater chance of bet more than a 50-50 of a possible rate hike in December. So there's a very good chance that we will have four rate hikes this year, as she tends to be very hawkish. Let's kind of move on here to the bond market. Here we're kind of the same level here. We're above the 25-day here, but we're bouncing off the 50-day moving average. We can't seem to get above that 50-day average, so it's kind of keeping this middle range here so far. So basically, rates are, there's no, basically we're at zero, so there's no change where pricing is in terms of pricing. So rates where we left off on Friday remain the same. 10-year Treasury, we're still below the 50-day moving average. We were lower, but we've kind of came back so far this morning. We're currently at about 2.93 on the 10-year Treasury. And if we can keep this ceiling here and keep this pressure lower, this will help out mortgage-backed securities and improve interest rates here. So that pretty much wraps things up. Rates are about the same. We'll keep this kind of short and sweet for you folks. If you guys want, if anything changes, I'll put updates on Twitter so you can follow me at Mike Bjork. Otherwise, I'll look forward to see you guys tomorrow. Thanks so much for watching. See you guys again tomorrow. Bye-bye.